Hi there, I'm Dokus, and today we'll get you started with your ATOS Q. In this tutorial, I will show you how you can measure big parts. Feel free to pause at any moment to follow along. There are also chapters if you wish to skip ahead. Let's get started. The ATOS Q has different measuring volumes. The biggest one is measuring volume 500. I've mounted this one and calibrated it so we can measure bigger parts. The door is a lot bigger than the 500 millimeters that we have, but that's not an issue. You can easily stitch scan to each other to measure bigger parts. I start with a new project and I select a scanning template. To make the scanning easier, I have mounted the ATOS Q on a mobile stand and I will use the remote. I can use the first position again to use the automatic cutout of the background. You can see that it works perfect, so I click on OK and I can continue. When scanning bigger parts, it's important that we stitch the reference points to each other. Our first shot defined already some reference points. If I move the sensor, you see in the software that the existing reference points in the previous scan already have a number and the new ones do not. When I make a new scan, I add the new reference points. With this technique, I can continue scanning and measure the complete door. When I have made enough scans, the complete door is digitized. You can see it's very easy to scan bigger parts. Thanks to the high quality of the ATOS Q, every small detail is captured, including the small holes next to the handle. If you experience anything different from what you have seen here, or if you have any issues with your ATOS Q, please reach out to us via HandsOnMetrology.com. For more tutorial videos, please check out our other videos. Thank you for watching, and we hope you see you next time.